Hello, Church Pastor Mike here. It's only been a week and a half, but it feels like it's been a long time since I've been able to see everybody. I wanted to reach out by video since I'm not able to be present this morning with everyone, to go ahead and give some thanks and give some updates. First off, for the thanks, I do want to say that we have been so well blessed and loved by this church family. It has been amazing, the outpouring of support and love, prayers, and lots of food that we've received in the past week and week and a half. It has been really encouraging for us through what really has been a tough time. It has been a hard time taking Jacob through the process of getting his heart surgery taken care of, seeing him at the hospital, being hooked up. Being there through the whole time, it has not been an easy time, but it has been a blessing just to see how the church has come together to love us well, and we so appreciate it. We've seen the power of prayer, as Jacob has done great and powered through many things and is healing up quickly, and we have really felt the support from everybody. We really appreciate it. Thank you, everyone. It has been, even through the challenges, a great time seeing what God is doing and how he works through his people. There was a verse I wanted to share, or a couple verses at the end of 1 Thessalonians, as Paul is rounding out the letter, that these thoughts came to mind as I was thinking of all the love that we have received. This is in 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, and it's verses 15, 16, and 17. And it says this here: "See that no one repays anyone evil for evil, but always seek to do good to one another and to everyone." Yeah, that is something that we have seen. Many people have done good to us, and we greatly appreciate it. "Rejoice always and pray without ceasing." I'll throw an 18 there for good measure. "Give thanks in all circumstances, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you." That's some good stuff for us to remember there. You know, we've walked through some challenges personally in my family, this church. We have a number of people who are walking through challenges right now. And even as we look, this nation is walking through some great challenges now. But we know this, that we can rejoice in the Lord always and in all things. That doesn't mean be happy in all things, but that means know that our hope is elsewhere. And we can cling to that and trust God for what he's doing in our lives right now. We know that in every circumstance, we can go before the Lord in prayer. He's always there, ready to hear our prayers. And that's us building our relationship with him. And all of this, as we do that, as we pray, as we love others, as we continue to rejoice, and as we give thanks to God, all of that is the will of God for our lives in Christ Jesus. And if we're in Christ Jesus, meaning we've accepted him as our Savior, that means this is the will of God in our life, to rejoice, to do good, to continue praying, and to give thanks, even through the hardships. We've been given many, many reasons to give thanks through what we walked through in this past week and a half, or past year as we've been waiting for the surgery, or even past 4 years, all the way back to when we first learned of Jacob's heart issues. There have been many times that we've been blessed and seen God at work, and it's been an encouragement for us. And this church has really, really stepped up to provide some of that for us. Again, thank you so much. But now, I'm sure you don't just want to see my face. Jacob has been doing wonderful, and I wanted to give you just a quick update on how he is doing right now. Right here, I have a few pictures here for y'all. This is a picture of him not too long after his operation. This was just, I think, 2 days after he had his open heart surgery. The doctors went in, and it was a very successful surgery. They were able to patch the hole. They were able to put the valve that was being pulled back into place, and they were able to stitch him up without any issues. There is a little concern with what they call an aortic cusp that has grown there, but it's one of those that it was safer to leave right now, as it usually means nothing. And if it develops in the future, we can handle it then with less risk than at this time. But Overall, it was a great surgery. The team out there in Rochester at Strong's Memorial, they were just wonderful. Really a great surgical team, great doctors. We were really appreciative of their work. And this is again a picture of Jacob as he started walking around finally, still with a few tubes attached, but getting around. He was up and walking as soon as he was able to. Much sooner than is expected. In fact, he moved through all the different steps of care, from the critical care unit to the just the standby intensive care, all the way to just a hospital room, in an amount of time that was surprising everybody, especially us, but even the doctors and nurses, as he just powered through the healing process. In fact, he came home on just about the earliest time frame they would really let him come home. The time frame we were given was 5 to 10 days, with 7 to 10 days being most likely. But he actually made it home on his fifth day after the surgery, bringing him home there on Wednesday. This is a picture of him walking around the hospital a little bit. He was off most of his tubes and lines at this time, and was able to get out and play a little bit. You can see him there with his heart warrior or heart hero cape on, and here he is in the playroom, being able to get out and enjoy some things here. And then finally, I do have a picture of him at home. It has been an interesting challenge the past 5 days or 4 days or so since he's been home, as the boy has tons of energy. But still has a chest that is healing up and a sternum held together by wires. And so trying to keep him from being rough and tumbling as normal has been an added challenge this past week. Even to the point of turning around on Saturday to see him having built a slide out of couch cushions and about ready to throw himself off of it. He is up and walking, wanting to run, wanting to play. Really, his recovery has been incredible. He's off of pretty much all pain meds at this point. He hasn't taken even basic pain meds like Motrin or Tylenol now in several days. And it's amazing. His heart is beating like normal. It has been quite the process. You can see him here at home in his comfy wear. If you're following on Facebook, I'm sure you've seen plenty of the updates as well, but we've been blown away by his progress. Again, we appreciate those prayers that have went into this, as God has clearly been at work in this little boy's life. And we just, again, want to say thank you for all of that, even as we lift thanks up to God for the work that he has done. Well, again, thank you. I cannot say it enough, but we so appreciate it. You guys have been such a blessing for us. I'm looking forward to hearing today Dan's message as he brings it. I'm also looking forward next week to being able to see more of you, hopefully on Wednesday night and next Sunday as we come together again for worship. We have a lot to be thankful for, but also remember we have a lot to be in prayer for, as we have families that are hurting, even our community, and we do have a nation that is hurting, even reeling right now, as we look at the sickness of our leader, President Trump. And I hope that we're all in prayer for him and in prayer for our government, as it has many, many major decisions to make in the next month before the election. All right. Well, you guys have a wonderful morning there. I'll see you. Bye.